I want to thank you for believing in me as your premier. I know it hasn't always been easy. Our government has made some tough decisions in the past 7 years.
In alphabetical order, Stephen McNeil, 700.
To extend my deepest appreciation on behalf of all of you and all Nova Scotians to their families. Only one name gets put on a ballot, but the entire family gets drafted into service. Tonight, you have entrusted our team with the great task of making this vision a reality. My commitment to you is that we will work tirelessly to ensure that we give you honest, hard-working government that you deserve.
If you consider for a moment the significance of that victory, Stephen's election in 2013 marked the first time in 131 years that a majority government wasn't re-elected. And that, of course, led to Stephen forming government and then forming, among other things, the most diverse cabinet in the history of the province.
My mother would have been smiling on an election night. Not because I became the premier, the fact that we elected more women to the House of Assembly than ever in our history. And I was so pleased to be able to say not one of them made it on gender. The men, I'm not so sure. We have the first female deputy premier. First female attorney general. Join us in this journey of optimism. Join us in this journey of taking advantage of the opportunities that are in front of us.
When you look at decisions we make and decisions we have made as government, you have to have strong leadership. And we certainly have had that strong leadership from Stephen. But we also knew that you have to set priorities. You can't say yes to everything. You have to identify which policy is going to give you the best results for the most Nova Scotians.
We were looking forward to do what was right for Nova Scotians. We weren't looking to be patted on the back to say that we've slayed the dragon of labor, because that's not at all what we've done. That's not at all what we attempted to do. It was never part of our conversation. The conversation was what's fair for Nova Scotians. What's our ability to pay?
You know, as government, we made some decisions that were not very popular, and we had labor unrest, we had protesters around the legislature. Those were difficult times. But I can tell you that when you know you've done the right thing, and when you know that many people are going to benefit from the decision you make, you can stand tall and weather the storm, and we did.
We raised the personal basic exemption so 500,000 Nova Scotians will see a tax cut. And the ones that will see the largest are the most vulnerable, lowest income in our province. That's what a Liberal government does when they have an opportunity to invest back into our province.
The Premier worked hard to open our province to the world and to welcome the world to our province. He helped us think big and has given us the confidence we need to succeed.
We've seen our seafood exports grow through the roof because of the great work of Minister Caldwell and what he's doing around the world, recognizing that we have the best seafood in the world and we value it and we expect people to pay the proper price so that we can come back here and invest in our community to continue to grow.
And through that, the Minister of Immigration has responded by creating new employment streams, a direct access. You are a new immigrant in Canada and you want to create a job and provide job opportunities, start a new business, we'll fast track your opportunity to come to Nova Scotia. If you find a job and are working there for a year with an employer in Nova Scotia, we'll fast track your opportunity to be here in Nova Scotia to help us build an economy. We need people.
He embraced immigration like no other premier. He knew that our population had to grow in order to grow the economy. and he believed in the positive effects of immigration. He believed that diversity is strength, and he took many steps to help make this province more welcoming and more inclusive.
It is absolutely critical that we as a province continue to open up our hearts and minds to new people. Over the last 2 years, we've welcomed more than 10,000 new Nova Scotians, the largest number since the end of the Second World War.
Andrea and Colleen are with me today. We had a chance to visit the Lieutenant Governor. You may have noticed somebody is missing, our son Jeffrey. At 1 p.m. this afternoon, the first sign was driven in the lawn in Annapolis County.
2017 campaign was very different than the 2013 campaign. In 2017, the Premier and his team were defending their record. And, you know, he took the same approach to organization and readiness, but it was a very tight election. It was up until election night. In fact, I remember distinctly being in Annapolis, and from the moment the bus arrived at headquarters until the moment he got on the stage, we went from a minority to a majority government.
I want to acknowledge Andrea, Colleen, and Jeffrey, who are here with me tonight. Many of you know they've campaigned for me, they've supported me, they put up with me, and I would not be standing here tonight without them. But we have proven as a province that when we work together, we are stronger and better, and that's the mandate you have given me tonight.
The 2017 re-election of a majority government marked the first time since the late 1940s that a Liberal had been elected to back-to-back majority governments.
We just introduced a universal pre-primary program that every four-year-old in this province, regardless of the socioeconomic circumstances they are born into, will get the right start in our province, and that is because of your hard work and dedication to the Liberal Party of Nova Scotia.
This really is an investment in our province, to ensure that every young person is given that same opportunity.
I think centres that were funded, the demonstration sites that were funded by the Nova Scotia government, and one in particular. And as I looked around, I thought to myself, these kids are getting better than I gave my kids.
The word that springs to my mind is trust. And I think that Nova Scotians have come to trust Stephen McNeil and what he stands for, even when they don't agree with any particular decision he makes. They still trust that he made the decision for the right reasons and on the basis of the right information. And I think that's unique in the world.
On behalf of the government of Nova Scotia, I want to apologize today to those who suffered abuse and neglect at the Nova Scotia Home for Colored Children.
When it came time to have the meeting with the Premier and we discussed what we wanted to do, he made it very clear that he wanted us, the former residents, to pick the design team. He wanted us, the former residents, to come up with the terms of reference. And he wanted us, the former residents, to have an inquiry that's in keeping with do no further harm. And he was true to form, and that's exactly what we did.
And I, as your government, or part of your government, am committed to ensuring that if there's a child in this province who comes into the care of your government, you at the very least have to have the commitment and understanding that they'll be cared for and loved and not hurt and harmed.
So on behalf of all Nova Scotians, thank you for your perseverance and your commitment to your families, to your communities, to your traditions, and to peace and friendship. And let this court be a symbol of your continued commitment and dedication to your communities. Today is the beginning of finding our way again. I, as the Premier of this province, want you to know our government, our province is committed to continuing down the path of reconciliation and healing.
And this is one of the hardest decisions that we as a government have had to make. The commitment I made to clean up Boat Harbor was a serious one, and not something our government did lightly. Many governments before us said they would clean it up, but did not. We will not repeat that pattern. The Boat Harbor Act will be enforced as of January 31st, 2020.
It's been a long time coming. I'm very grateful to Premier Stephen McNeil.
I think that people understand that governments, premiers, have to make difficult decisions, and God knows he's had to make a lot of them. But I think they understand that when he made a decision, as tough as it was, and perhaps as unpopular as it was at the time, he did it on the basis of the right information, and he wasn't afraid to make difficult decisions.
Mr. Speaker, organ and tissue donation is near and dear to the hearts of many Nova Scotians. I can tell this House it is a priority of our government and to me personally. Organ and tissue donation not only saves lives, it gives hope to those waiting for life-saving transplants.
Mr. Speaker, most people agree with donations, but don't specify on their license. Bruce was one of those. Imagine, Mr. Speaker, the lives of four people who are alive today, and their junior generations follow them that are alive because of Bruce's final gift. I want to thank the Premier for being a champion of this bill. He will never know the full impact it will make on the lives of Nova Scotians.
And some of you have a physician that you know is getting ready to retire. I want you to understand that we know that, the health authority knows that, and it continues to be our number one priority.
Good evening and thanks for joining us. It is now official. Canada has its first confirmed case of the new strain of coronavirus.
We will be doing everything possible in our province to ensure when this gets here, we have done the due diligence to prevent the spread. I want us to be the province in Canada that has actually made sure that we dealt with this the most professional way and the best way collectively. So your role in this is critical. We are dealing with a deadly virus, and this behavior is unacceptable. And so today, effective immediately, I am declaring a provincial state of emergency. When all we have to do is stay the blazes home.
Our system of justice, from policing to courts to corrections, have failed many members of our Black community. A system that is supposed to keep you safe, but because of the color of your skin, you fear it. Today, I say enough. I want you to know, I hear you, I see you, I believe you, and I am sorry. One of the most important things that we try to do as a province and as a government is to ensure that every citizen sees themselves reflected in our communities.
It's great to see you this way. I miss seeing you in person. You look so happy. We should have done this months ago. Would have made my life so much easier.
Hello, Mr. Prima. It's me, your Miss Katie. And we have been best friends since 2015.
I think Premier McNeil has always showed compassion and understanding for Nova Scotians. And in his capacity as Premier, he wanted to make sure that any legislation and any policies that we put forward demonstrated that compassion.
Today, the face of Nova Scotia is changing. Our population is growing. Our economy is strong despite the pandemic. And this is the legacy of Stephen McNeil.
I attribute Stephen McNeil's success to the fact that he's focused, he's pragmatic, he's authentic, he's determined. You may not always agree with him, but you respect his position. And I think most importantly, he never takes himself too seriously, which is important in a job like Premier.
Many people lose their bearings at some point along the way. They forget where they came from. They forget what they stand for. And Stephen McNeil has never done that. And I think that's to his credit. And that's not made the decisions easier, but I'm sure that it's given him a sense that at the end of the day, if you can look yourself in the mirror and know that you're doing the right thing for the right reasons, that's success. And that's Stephen McNeil.
I love this job. I've enjoyed every day of it. And every day I'm inspired by the people of this province. But this is not a lifelong career. I have always believed that governing is not about power, it is about purpose. And I want to thank Nova Scotians for giving me the opportunity to be your premier. I may not have always gotten it right, but here's what I know for sure. We are better together, and being kind matters.